married in 2004, and I joined this commission with my husband the same year. Along the line, we have been believing God for the fruit of the womb. And we did everything medically, and they said that my husband had a low sperm count. We tried everything medically to conceive. Nothing happened.
When the result came that I would not be able to impregnate my wife, and the doctor said that he's going to give us some medication, and he did everything he said he's going to do, and after that, nothing happened. At the end of it all, that was when we now said that we are going to focus our mind on God. My backup was that God is my maker, that He is the one that created me in His image and after His likeness. Low sperm count was not there. Watery sperm was not there. And Papa do mention that children are the heritage of the Lord, which means it's God that gives children. Whether you have excess of sperm count or you don't even have at all.
In 2013, Papa had special service for those that believe in God for the fruit of wombs. I and my husband, we attended the service at Rajoba. And along the line of the service, Papa said that the Holy Spirit prompted to him to lay hands on those that believe in God on fruit of the womb, that some people's case was not ordinary. I said that service was my service. And during the time of laying hands, I stood up on my chair. He now made a statement, said that the children that God is going to give to us, no devil will tamper with the children. I said amen, and I believe it strongly. 2 months later, I was feeling somehow sick, headache and fever, and I went to the hospital. There, they tested me pregnancy positive. I couldn't believe my eyes. I went to another hospital. It was the same, positive. Along the line, after 1 month, I started seeing blood, which lasted for good 4 months. I went back again for them to check. Scan check said there was nothing like a baby inside me, but the pregnancy test tested positive again. So that was how the journey began. For good 7 years that I was carrying this pregnancy, I went through a lot. There was a lot of mockery everywhere. Even my family members mocked at me. People mocked at me, gave me names, which I couldn't bear. Some said that because I'm desperate to have a child, I want to take injection to form that I'm pregnant. But the word of faith and my Christian people around me, including my husband, stood beside me and encouraged me. And I went through that journey as if nothing was happening.
When they came to our zone, the pregnancy was due to be delivered. And I make it a point of duty to get close to her. And the husband encouraged them, pray along with them every moment, every time.
Then we decided to come to Canaanland to come and see Papa. Then we saw Papa. He said I should relax, that the baby will come. He now prayed for me. He rebuked the barrier on my path and declared divine intervention, and I had peace. In the year 2020, June 28th, I delivered my baby successfully without operation. To God be all the glory.